142. What kind of name is that? Sounding like you named yourself after your neighbour's gaff. That's how I approach battles, tongue in cheek. You approach every battle with aggressive bars like you forgot you're weak. And that's why battling you, it's hard to fail. Cause no one buys into that aggressive approach, so you can't prevail, you ain't swinging nobody at it. Those arms are frail, I mean, you know your toughest side is failed when you make Callum Martin look hard as nails. You're such a fucking gimp. I bet when people ask your age, you reply 19 and 3 quarters. Such a fucking gimp, I bet you put toilet paper down before you sit to make the seat warm. You're such a fucking gimp, when you go for a curry, I bet you're the guy who says, I don't mind spicy stuff, I just like to taste my food. And then proceed to eat korma. And I can't respect that level of giddiness. All your fake aggressive dolls fitting. I can't respect the way you allow yourself to be one of Mickey and Hulk's bitches. So to give you the full picture, one wrong move and this game's getting knocked out like that scene in Pulp Fiction. No, no.
Yeah. Nah, that joke's just dead now. It was something that you started off saying, and then it became a wave to sweat round. Did you really think I was gonna let it get to me? That I would have wept? All too happy with my head down? Nah, I've come into battle for the respect that I feel that I should get now. You should call me out in public just to try and get some cheap laughs. And behind the scenes, we're genuine friends. And that's something that I'm happy to see pass. So don't act like you're one thing, you're a bad man that loads clips. So I'll happily kill a friend to assert my dominance like God Freak. You're about to get you promptly. And he didn't break a bad boy, that's all out of place. Well fuck you if you think that. Come and say it to my face, cause he drops an office bar in every battle. And I'm the one that's out of date, gets the crowd pushed by saying something that was once said by Ricky Gervais. So fuck you if you don't think I should be here. Bitch, you know that I've earned my spot. Going through more paper in my notepad than there is paper at Warren and Hog. You can't do it like me, David. You just can't rap with this caliber. So now I'm taking over this joker's spot like when Gareth Keener became manager. Now I'm sorry if no one's the office, but I was just proving to you that that's easy to do. And I easily prove that my thesis is true. This is pink for you, dude. Cause if you come with bars like that today, you're gonna be leaving here with a red top. It's quite clear you are no soul. Slow it down. You have a red top, so it's quite clear you have no soul. But look, do what you need to do, David. Call me a gimp or bring out some white addicts to try and get the crowd onto your side. Talk about how you're always banging that 4-5. Try and make me nervous like a defendant sitting in court telling all lies. Cause I know that I'm gonna outbar and outperform me today. So I don't even need to try and get into your mind. Cause this is like Happy Gilmore. You're gonna stand there and call me names to try and put me off my game. Cause that's just what you're like. But I've got this shit down to a T. So try that at me and I'll run at you swinging. I ain't talking about the war drive. That's what I call time, run out of breath. Fuck yeah.
There's been some shit battlers this year. Like Tiny K, HKM, Otis Green. So you make those three peeps look like Tony D. Cause you flow real weak. Now you won't beat me. Cause I'm on my Phil Taylor skis. I'll make finishing 142 look so easy. I'll make finishing 142 look so easy. Now be honest, Alex. How much did Brock Wilson pay you to go try his third round? You must have been behind such dull writing. Cause of all the battlers to grace don't flop, you're the worst that Earth's found. Your style's so predictable and we don't find it exciting. You're like Bart Simpson in them opening credits. Cause you repeat line after line in your writing. And you've got no charisma. So you're about as confident battling as Conqueror is travelling. Standing through your rounds is often quite challenging. So why not do us all a favour, Alex? Take a leaf out of Conqueror's book and opt to start cancelling. Shooting on every channel. And your performances have been some of the poorest I've seen. You've been putting in shit performances whilst passing through leads like Portsmouth FC. You embarrass yourself time and time again. Like that time Fanta pulled out a spoon on you. You jumped back, but then took 2 further steps. What the fuck did you think he was going to do to you, Alex? Stir you to death? Soft pussy. As a kid, Alex was homeschooled. Still got bullied.
So what you guys might not know, 5 or 6 years ago, David here helped set up an event. Got some tryouts, helped with the venue, but then the camera was needed and your time as a staff member went into the sink. Cause their messages you started evading. Face it, David, you got replace it. The flex digits wanted to smash invasion, but that was you off the staffing team. But he wasn't a staff member all that time ago, so let me put that into perspective for those that are gassed. That means he was a staff member before Osh was champ. That means he was a staff member before I was banned. That means he was a staff member before I passed my exam. Back now, right? Knowing that you could have been a solid part of the team, and with all that experience, it's unlikely but possible that you could have been top 10, but instead you're here battling me at training days again. But it's not all bad though, because there were a few points holding the rent for it, supported by the masses. On his tryout, they came back to lose his last two clashes, because the stuff that you had just wasn't top draw. Motherfucker, you're not on form. We can see the curve that you're living on like we're sitting on the Concorde. Yeah, you ain't got bars like that, you ain't got flow like that, your obvious punchlines and single syllable rhymes can't put on a show like that. So go back to the viewpoint in time that I had a nice couple lines in my rhyme pad that only has hate for these outcasts like Minecraft. I mean, why would you want to step into the ring with me? I am so skilled, I've got the plans to run out for this body like Michael Schofield. I'm so ill.
That's enough about setting up an event. Facts, man, Flex did want to punch me. I can say facts, man. I turned up 5 years later, Flex judged my tryout. Bad man. Now let's be real. You're the new Matt Sherry. I wanted to list every reason why in this round. Had to pick a top three because there's that many. Like, that's training days. You got dropped by Calamari. That's training days. You got dropped by Calamari and it didn't matter. So we know swinging arms ain't you. You got dropped by Calamari. What next? Pocket check by J. Cruz? Then there was the time that Big Daddy Beach made this bitch Alex Queef. When he pulled out a heart, he proceeded to spit in your feet. Yet again, you showed you weren't a striker. Cause we expected it to pop off. But when one on one with heart in your feet, you failed to get a shot off. Now when K-Shine got his hat fucked with, he slapped Sharon and made a bitch of Corey. When you got your hat fucked with, you stood there stunned then turned to relapse like, hit it for me. Turned to relapse like, hit it for me. But I ain't coming with antics today, cause I don't need to rely on shit like that to get cheap laughs off these fans. Nah, I'll dead him in three, man. Cause I'm like Mario with white overalls. I create fire rounds with these hands. And it's for that reason there ain't a chance you might win. So fuck 142, aka Mr. Right Gim.
So when most people go to a fancy dress party, they go with something stupid but fun. But not this mug, because he went to a party dressed up as Sanka from Cool Runnings. And that's great, but can you explain to everyone here why you went painting yourself with a black face? Do you know what reminds you dressed up as Sanka? No question from Santa. You're getting cold when you're sloppy this shit, where you don't really hear race that. You're lucky that I deleted that piece at ASAP, and I wouldn't be surprised if outside this black team with a straight chat were getting cold when you're talking. Something black, man, I bet you're really gonna hate that. Because being a racist? Now come on, David, that really is a poor trait. I mean, when you did it, did you not realise that you would be taken into poor taste and it's ironic? You even called me a gimp in the first place, when you're the one that's going out and marking up your face. And it's written. Why you were never gonna be the best. But picture him being the best. No, really, envision it, witnessing it, killing shit. Going mad like Villain did on that Tommy Villain snip and picking up pyramids. Stepping into the ring and kicking it with real lyrics, acting all high spirited. On his Genghis Khan shit, pillaging villages and finishing villages, cause I can't see that. So you can talk about me being a skinny twig or mention how I used to rap fish and chips, but I'm still militant like Bradley Cooper and Limitless. Cause every time I get in it, I try and kill the pit like Mr. and Mrs. Smith. And in your battle against Lex, you said that you always keep that hammer ready, and you'll put that 4-5 in his back, that's Balotelli. Well, if you can do gun bars, then I can too, faggot. Cause when I hit you with that stunner, you'll be out slow pole by Medusa. Cause I came here to show you the meaning of pain with these punches, motherfucker, I'm a groomer. Cause when I trip the Bruger, I'll have pumping at your chest like the Heimlich maneuver.